How are you?
Doing great, thank you.
Good. So, are you with IDO?
She is, I guess, just a citizen here to photo, just a...
I'm Peter.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Nice to see you. Yeah.
I'm sorry, your name is?
Peter.
Peter, it's a pleasure.
Yeah, welcome.
Thank you.
Can I get you a water or a Coke?
Actually, a water would be wonderful.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Sure.
I appreciate your offering.
Ms. Tisdale, I believe, is that your...
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you for asking.
I've seen you at some of the board meetings and stuff, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll give you my card. Just give me a card.
I'm sorry.
I'll give you my card. Thank you so
sure.
much.
Sure.
Appreciate that. Thanks.
I just emailed Daisy, so... So are you a photographer by profession, or these are gorgeous.
Thank you. No, it's a hobby.
Oh, okay. My father's retired and has gotten involved with the Cherokee County Photography Association, and he is just definitely has a new hobby, which my mother loves in retirement, so yeah.
So he is, but yeah. I'm a sunshine proponent.
And as that being?
Georgia Sunshine Mom.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
House Bill 397.
We refer to it as the open meetings, right? Yeah.
Right, that's on your agenda today.
So, right, yeah. Since the new law that went into effect is now impacting.
How are you?
Hello, Mr. Linda. I'm doing well, thank you.
How are you doing today? I'm glad you successfully
ran back from Cherokee.
Don't you love that drive every day? Oh, that's the drop I had every day, so.
Yeah.
So. Yep, one of those are for you. One's Daisy, and Peter's there at the end, so.
Motion petition was filed yesterday. We received notice of it at 4 o'clock yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I received that then at 4:20.
Right, right.
And, you know, drafted all my motions and responses, you know, until about 9:30, 10 o'clock last night.
Oh, great. Fun. Yeah, he sits on the senior judge status here, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
So then we get there, and he made us mediate it out. Which was fine.
Y'all prefer that, right?
Well, I mean, I think I would have won on the merits. Yeah. I can't do it, but I don't know. At the end of it, it would have taken just as much time, probably.
Right.
Or
well,
less,
you
frankly.
You got to a resolution.
Yep.
So, yeah.
So there it is.
Okay. Yeah, that construction on 20
mm-hmm.
adds probably 15 minutes to my commute every day. Which I'm glad that they do it, but they do position officers there quite frequently.
Yes.
Which is, you know.
Mm-hmm. Hey.
Who are we waiting on?
Are you
Daisy?
She sent you.
She hadn't responded.
No, that's right. Where she's
at. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. I'm the Indigent Defense Administrator for the county.
It's a pleasure to meet
you.
You too.
We are in place of a public defender's office. We use the private local attorney, so I manage the office and appoint the attorneys for all the individuals who meet the guidelines. So.
Okay. Thanks for explaining that.
Oh, you're welcome. How are you doing today?
Okay.
I didn't even see you. How was your cruise?
It was good until I got sick on the last day. But fortunately, it was the last day, so when I got quarantined,
yeah, you were fine.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Good afternoon.
How are you doing?
All right.
We all want to shift down and put them all in there. I'll sit here at the line of sight camera.
Well,
okay.
Welcome everybody.
Welcome.
We'd like to start, Connie. We're going to start with Roman numeral 1.
We sure will. Just need to call the meeting to order. We do have all parties. Peter, the chairman, Tom, and Daisy are here. First thing is adoption of the meeting agenda. We already provided a copy with the meeting agenda. Are there any suggested additions to the meeting agenda?
Unless I need to ask, I'm just here to ask for a new attorney to be added to the appointed list. I don't know if that has to be on the agenda or not.
It does, yes, Mr. Banks.
I just had a couple of questions, not necessarily about appointment, but just a couple of questions.
Would one of the committee members like to add that to the agenda under new business? You said add an attorney to the panel?
Yes. Huh?
Yes, I'll make that motion.
I second.
A motion by Peter, a second by Tom to add new attorney panel request for Mr. Banks.
And
all in favor?
Any opposed? All right.
Okay. Unanimous to do that. Okay.
And also, Mr. Adams is inquiring. Okay. I'll move to allow that to be on the agenda.
Second.
You may ask what the inquiry is about.
Are there any written policies about adopting attorneys or privatizing? Is there a list of attorneys from privatized I could have? Something like that.
Okay. Do I hear a motion and a second to put that on the agenda?
Yes, I move to add that to today's agenda.
Yes.
Okay. That will be placed under the new business. Any other additions or deletions from the agenda?
No.
I ask for a motion to approve the agenda as amended.
Motion to approve.
Tom, is there a second?
Second.
Peter, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. All right, moving on to the next agenda is the adoption of the minutes. Y'all have been provided a copy of the minutes from the last meeting. If y'all want to review those, see if there's any changes to the minutes. Motion to approve the minutes.
Motion to approve.
Tom, second.
Second.
Your second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. All right, moving on to the next thing is the old business. Last meeting we talked about having a panel attorney meeting. Some of the attorneys are new on the panel. Some have not had updates. I'm not saying they haven't looked at the manual, but you don't know. So y'all talk about having a meeting. We put it off until this meeting to deter, I guess, to get a little closer for everybody to look at their schedules. Do y'all have a preferred date or when y'all would prefer that it be done? Trial week, or do y'all want to? How do y'all want to handle that?
When is the TAC conference in July?
Yes, it is. Thank goodness they put that on the calendars. TAC conference is the week of July the 23rd. That is also, Judge Dickinson has Superior Court civil bench trials, and the first 3 days is the PAC conference. The last 3 days is the Council of Superior Court Judges Conference. So there's no...
Should be a quiet week.
It should be a quiet week. So, preferred date as of Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Thursday. I mean, for the attorneys, what tends to be a... Because we're looking at 40-some-odd attorneys that we're going to have to try to get in, and we may have to have like a morning meeting and then an afternoon meeting, or I hate to get that many meetings together, but to get all the attorneys there.
Do we have a date set for the defense bar meeting?
No, I'm working on that right now. We're going to try to have a meeting in July during that week.
Okay.
There's a new courthouse audio visual system that they're installing.
Yes.
And I've been communicating with Dawn Childress to try to get some training for the attorneys on the new equipment.
Okay.
So we're going to try to arrange that after they've installed it in July.
Okay.
So we try to do it in tandem with that, you know, seminar, if you will, on the new equipment, so they can do PowerPoints at trial.
Okay. How long do you think our meeting would be with the panel attorneys? An hour?
The last one that we did was, depending on questions from the panel, just for me to, you know, go over the thing, an hour at the most.
Because we could try to do it before the training thing.
Right.
We want to try to combine it on one day.
Yes.
Instead of having to do 2 days that week.
Probably get better attendance, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Okay. How long do you think it would take?
Probably about an hour, depending on questions from the panel and everything. So the attorneys have questions.
Yeah.
So maybe we could do like a panel and then break for lunch and then come and do the training in the afternoon or something like that.
Or start the
training
at 10, transition into the tutorial on the audiovisual equipment.
Okay.
And then go to lunch, whatever.
Mm-hmm. I mean, if they're going to do it probably in the courtroom like Dawn's done it before, we could do it all in the courtroom. Then everybody would be already be in the courtroom.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think that's probably the best
plan. Well, we can put it off until our June meeting. You think you'd hear something about that from Dawn by then?
Yes, I actually have something back nailed down today.
Okay. So, you want to postpone further discussion of this until we get the exact date from Dawn?
Yeah.
Okay. Do I hear a motion to move this to the next meeting after we get a date from Dawn for the training?
I make a motion.
Second by Tom. All in favor?
Aye.
Good deal. Okay. Next thing on the agenda is new business. We will flip to the new business. We are going to be discussing review of our current budget matters. The first one that you see will be our March monthly budget statement. You are familiar with reading those. The month of March, we had 75% of the year remaining, and the indigent defense budget was at 81.97%. So we were about right at 7% of the budget remained to the good, so we didn't really get on that. The April budget, we had 67% of the budget year remaining. I dropped down to 70%. If you will flip to the second page of the April budget, there is a star. If you will notice that on our Superior Court indigent budget, we are down to 57.85%. I was really concerned about that. I had a meeting with our finance director and we went over everything. Come to find out, due to the number of capital cases, the death penalty cases that we have, Forsyth County is required by law to provide a percentage of representation to the state. And we got an astronomical bill of like $60,000-$70,000 from the state for our portion of the last capital case. So that is why, and normally they've had individual budgets set up per each defendant on a capital case, but the county has changed that and they are putting all of that back into indigent defense. So any portion that this, we have to pay the state is going to come out of my budget. So that is why we are down to 57% in the Superior Court budget, is because the monies that we owe the state.
Did they send you an invoice in that case?
They did. They
which case was it?
It was the McGee case, the Jason McGee case, the farmhouse shooting.
Okay.
That was the one that I sent to the county attorney, and they reviewed it.
Was it an itemized bill also?
Not as itemized as we would like for them to be, but it was itemized enough that we were able to, you know, I was able to compare dates and stuff, so. And the county attorney's office approved that, and it is in accordance to state mandate, so. So that is why the county is aware of that. I will, again, keep them apprised monthly as to how that line item is going. They are aware that if it comes down, that they may have to give us additional funding for Superior Court. We do have additional capital cases that are pending right now. There are two that is along with Mr. McGee that just pled that are still pending. Ms. Penn has pulled one of those off the death penalty, so it is now totally coming back to us, where we will have to fund the remainder of that. So
previously was being funded out of county funds?
No, it was previously being funded out of the state.
Okay.
Because it was a capital case, but once it becomes a non-capital case, then it comes back locally to the jurisdiction here.
Okay. But the new part that you, that's now coming out of your budget, mm-hmm. was there any money extra that goes in your budget to make up for that?
Not at this point. If it does come down to that point, then the county will have to address it at that time.
Okay.
So. Okay. So just didn't want y'all to freak out when y'all saw that come out yet. So any questions about the budget reviews for monthly? Okay.
I'd like to recognize our guest, Mr. Banks. I think he has a question related to that.
Connie, I was curious about the impact of capital cases on the indigent defense budget. Mm-hmm. Is the DA's office aware of the huge impact their actions have on the tripartite and indigent defense budget?
Ms. Penn has been privy to some of the meetings that we've had when we would get together to address how much the county was going to be impacted on it. I can't say for sure if she knows exactly, but she is aware that the county now is having to fund monies.
That's a pretty good hit.
It is a big hit. That case occurred in 2006, so it's 6 years old. So
is she invoiced? Like, does she see the actual?
No, she does not.
The price tag?
No. I mean, my budget is public. Anybody most county employees can run other departments' budgets, but I don't tend to run other departments' budgets. I'm sure she doesn't either, so.
Just curious, thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Banks.
The next things under the budget is just our attorney restitution fees from the state of Georgia. There are three checks. One is in the amount of $314, one is in the amount of $223, and the other one is in the amount of $157. These are fees that people who are placed on probation pay their probation. The judges will order a reimbursement of attorney fees to the defendants, and they are required to pay those fees to the probation. So those are what we receive from the state of Georgia, felony probation. Oh, I'm sorry, there's two additional ones. There's another one for $68 and another one for $160. Why they send those not in one check, I don't know. The following ones from Georgia Probation Management are for the misdemeanor probation. One check is in the amount of $1,368. The other one is in the amount of $176. The next item underneath your budget is our state indigent defense reimbursement that the state provides us. We get quarterly checks from the state since we are an opt-out county from the Public Defender's Office. This is a quarterly check for $41,046. So we get that four times a year, and it fluctuates on our caseload. Depending on how many felony cases we have, it fluctuates depending on that. So any questions so far about the restitution we've got? Okay. The last thing under the budget is our 2013 preliminary budget. This is the preliminary budget that I have submitted for 2013. I have met with the finance committee going over this with them, answered any questions that they had regarding it. justified any, again, like I just did with y'all, advising them of how many capital cases we have, how many major felony cases that we have pending right now, which does impact our budget considerably. So our budget right now, it's 6.18% less than what it was last year. But they have taken out some, what they consider to be internal service charges, where they used to bill us for public facilities, IT and stuff, which they're no longer billing us for those. Those are going into a different account. So if y'all want to review that, ask to have any questions for me. I did go over this with y'all, I think, previously at the last meeting that we went into and advised you of that. So any questions about the budget items? Okay. The next thing is, well, some attorney invoices and investigator invoices. The first one is attorney Russell Hetzel has submitted an invoice on a rape aggravated sexual battery case. This is in accordance with our policies. The Tripartite Committee has to review any invoices that are over our ceiling. This case has a ceiling of $5,000 on it. His invoice is approximately $10,000. He has written a detailed statement as to a letter as to why his billings went over our policies and procedures. I can tell you, I've researched this. Mr. Hetzel had to use a DNA expert on this. His client adamantly said that it was not him. A DNA expert was used. It confirmed what the findings previously were. His client still demanded a trial. So there was another couple of experts that were used for various reasons dealing with the victim statements and things. It was a very extensive case.
My recommendation is this case already been concluded?
It has been concluded. He was found guilty. So
does he have a written explanation for the overage?
There's a two-page written explanation. Yeah. So my recommendation.
I recognize Mr. Banks.
Just an observation. They are in the same building I'm in. I can tell you from personal experience, they worked a lot of long nights.
They did. And he even has a young associate with him that he didn't bill for any of his hours. And his associate put in time just to help him out on it. So my recommendation, I do know it is considerable, but due to the charges, due to the hours that he's got here, due to my contact with him, dealing with experts and stuff, my recommendation to the committee is to approve the invoice.
And Connie, I have not had a chance to read his explanation, so I'd like to have an opportunity to do that.
Sure.
And so I'd like to move to vote on that at the next meeting.
Okay.
After I have an opportunity to look at the explanation.
Okay.
Because it's twice the amount that, and I just think it's appropriate for us to have a chance to look at that first and not vote on it today.
Okay. There's a motion. Do I have a second that we put this off to voting on for the next meeting?
Second
by Tom. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Well, I'll put that on the agenda for next and give you a chance to, everybody a chance to review it.
Thank you.
The next one is also an interim invoice from Ms. Shelley Hawkins. This is a misdemeanor case. The case, it is a underage possession of alcohol and then a misdemeanor possession of marijuana.
Is it a pending case or is it already?
No, these are already disposed of. This was a case, Ms. Hawkins was appointed in May of 2010, so the case is 2 years old. She has submitted a previous interim invoice for $988. Her final invoice is for $1,854. Which brings the total now for billings to $2,843. This is also above the 2,000 ceiling that for misdemeanor cases, according to the policy, has to be reviewed by the Tripartite Committee.
It looks like this case actually went to trial.
It did go to trial, yes. And I also have attached her interim invoice behind her original invoice for y'all to review. And Ms. Hawkins did drop off a letter this morning to my office that I have attached to. And actually, she also brought her trial notebook, which was one of the 4-inch binders. She wanted to leave it for me if the Tripartite Committee wanted to go over the trial notebook. But I advised her, I think her letter would be sufficient since it was very detailed. So,
Kanye, I'd like to recognize our guest, Mr. Banks. I think he has a question.
Well, it's not so much a question. Obviously, I haven't seen the bill, but I will just observe that in relation to the period of time, the fact that there was a trial, and in relation to what the private market would charge, that's a pretty reasonable bill.
I would like to point out that the letter here indicates that there actually, I don't think there was a trial on the third page, on the second page of the letter, that they were going to pick a jury, but then they actually never got to that part of the solicitor was actually dismissed.
I haven't read her, like I said, she just wrote the letter off right prior to me coming here, so I do know it was on several calendars.
It was on several calendars, apparently because of Judge Smith continuing it.
Repeatedly.
For several days.
Yeah.
But no actual trial itself, just time waiting in court.
Right. And I did notice that she had, that there was one day she spent like 4 hours waiting in court, came back after lunch, waiting for, because Judge Smith directed her to wait in case the case did not go,
So may I ask you a question?
Yes, the chair recognizes Mr. Banks.
So the state ultimately dismissed the case?
Correct.
Okay. To my view, that's the mark of a good attorney, to know when the state doesn't have a case and you make them, you wait them out.
I'm going to agree with Mr. Banks on 2 statements he's made. The panel attorney, especially Ms. Hawkins, is very diligent about her time and matters and stuff. And again, I feel this is an appropriate billing for the case, but again, it's just so the policies, I have to refer to the Tripartite Committee for a decision on it.
I approve it.
Motion by Peter to approve it. Do I hear a second?
A second.
Any other further discussion or all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Approve it. The next one is a invoice from Miss Mindy Smith. This is a transcript from Appalachian Court Reporting. It's a transcript of a client's plea. When I checked with Miss, when I got the invoice, I checked with Miss Smith to find out why she requested it, and y'all got copies of my email correspondence between myself and Miss Smith. She advised me that she wanted to make sure that he had a true and current correct copy of all his obligations under probation. This was entered as non-negotiated plea. She wanted to make sure all his bases were covered and that she didn't miss anything. My response to her was, since his probation conditions would be listed on his sentence and he would be provided a copy of his sentence, I can't approve the transcript. Her final was normally when she orders a transcript, they're $50 to $60. And I called her and personally and spoke with her on the phone, and she advised me that she requests copies of all of her pleas, transcripts of all of her pleas.
I would like to move to reserve discussion of this till after executive session. I'd like to discuss this further there.
Okay.
There's some legal aspects, I think, to it that might have to be considered, and then have a vote on it afterwards.
Okay. Do you want to table after executive session?
Correct.
Okay. You're a second?
Second.
Okay. Any objections or approvals? Maybe to the after executive session?
I have no objection.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's all of the other things that we need to discuss other than our, and the budget-wise.
May I just interrupt?
Yes.
Since we're transitioning, we have 2 guests. I know they've been approved to speak, and I'm going to hold them up. I think Mr. Banks was the first that we approved today to address the committee. So if it's acceptable, I'd like to interject and allow him to do that, since I know he's got a busy day and I don't want to hold him up. But Mr. Banks, you have the floor.
Thank you. I'd just like to ask the committee to add Ms. Cindy English to the panel. She's a recent graduate of Georgia State Law School, has passed the bar, started working in our firm the 1st of January, has been admitted to the Georgia Court of Appeals. Supreme Court admission is pending. Like to have her added to the misdemeanor / juvenile court panel.
Do you have a copy of her resume that you can provide to us? Do we have that?
I can.
I don't have a copy of her resume.
I can send one to you. Interesting. She's closer to my age.
Okay.
Most new attorneys.
Do you know how many people are waiting to be on the misdemeanor panel? If any.
My last recollection is, and I don't separate misdemeanor from felonies, my last recollection, I have about 25 or 30 requests to be on our panel in general.
I see.
But if we, I'll be glad to have the committee review it at the net. If we can get a copy of her resume, there are policies and procedures that require a certain amount of time practicing law. So the committee would need to review that.
All right, if you could send that to me.
Sure.
We'll do everything we need to do to comply.
Okay, I'll forward you a copy of our requirements.
Okay, and may I be excused.
Mr. Banks, it's always a pleasure. Thank you. You're welcome to come back anytime.
Thank you.
And we have another guest, Jerry Adams. We've approved his desire to speak to the committee today. So the chair recognizes Mr. Adams. Mr. Adams, you have the floor.
My question is mostly ministerial, like Mr. Banks. One of them was, is there a form to apply on for private detectives and or attorneys? Is there a limit of private detective attorneys on the list of qualifications for either both? And a copy of the rules they have to go by. If you want me to submit that to you in an email, I can do that, and you just reply back that way if you want to.
I'm gonna have to defer to the county attorney's office if that's something that's pretty on that open records, or would that be something I could do?
Well, I can take a look at it to determine. I believe your policies and procedures should be something that we can discuss, but just
if you'll just provide me in writing exactly what you want, so okay, we know exactly what you're asking for,
Other question was, I know that previously I was turned down, but I know Stan Rutledge, my friend, had applied, and he's not able to be here today. He never got a reply from anybody about whether he was going to be on the committee or not, so he would like to know to him why he was or was not put on the panel. Okay. That was last year sometime, I think.
Okay. If you'll have him also send me a written request, and be glad to follow up on it for you.
And may I be excused?
Of course. Thank you, Mr. Rouse. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thanks.
Come back anytime. Thank you, Connie, for...
Oh, you're welcome. Not a problem. Getting back to the agenda, the next thing is, I guess what everybody's talking about, well, at least for the county, is the new law requiring the Open Meetings Act. We have been trained by our county attorney, Ken Gerard, as to the requirements of what the law now has. Actually, Mr. Gerard did training for the county commissioners recently at their annual meeting. I have provided y'all with a copy of his PowerPoint presentation, which goes into great detail on this, since Mr. Gerard helped write the legislation. And I can tell, and Melissa has gone to training, I've gone to training to ensure that we comply with the open meetings portion. We did comply. We are now required to prepare public notices and agendas for our meetings, as you know, we're not. Notify the media. We posted in public places that the county has a list of. So we are notifying the public and following the open record or open meetings act that is now in place. There is a request by Mr. Gerard, not only for this committee, but for some other committees. We're not quite sure where we fall as far as the legislation goes. So the Attorney General's office is actually, since we technically are judicial related, we're not, he's actually requested an opinion from the Attorney General's office, if technically, but until that time, we are going to follow it just like we are. So, but again, I've given y'all a PowerPoint presentation. I've even got my notes here, which I can make y'all copies of or update those, just so that you know what my personal notes were. So with that being said, any questions about general without going into great detail? Ken did a really good job about that. So But with that being said, the committee needs to decide. I know our bylaws say we need to meet monthly. And I know with everybody having different obligations, we need to get a regular meeting date scheduled so that it can be publicized and put on the county, you know, put on the websites and everything.
How much advance notice do you need?
I have to give a minimum of a week, 7 days notice of, you know, the meeting notice and an agenda.
But, you know, all three of the members of the committee were all litigators, so
that's
our day can change right in a second. So I think,
and as we know, I mean, we've had, y'all called me before and said, look, I'm tied up in court. A quorum is two of the three members. So, and our bylaws say that as long as there's a two members here, that the meeting can be conducted. So,
and we have a very high success rate of getting everyone together on a monthly basis. So,
we do. Yeah.
If we set the meeting out 2 weeks in advance, then we can put in our conflict letter and you can have time to post it.
Peter, let me ask you this question. Do you, for the county bar, you have a monthly meeting?
No, we are quarterly.
Quarterly, mm-hmm. Okay.
For the defense bar.
Okay. I was going to say we could simply tie it into that, but if that's not a monthly option, then we can't do that.
It's quarterly. At least this year, we're trying it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The general bar meets the second Friday of each month, but the defense bar is quarterly.
I think the process you've been following works pretty well. I think we have more than 90% success ratio of getting everybody here on a monthly basis. So.
Especially a quorum, I think that I don't think we have any issue getting quorum together. So So just continue the beginning of the month. Just start contacting y'all for potential dates. So, and just so y'all know, I have to have 7 days. You know, if I want to do the 7 days, but normally we can do it within 2 weeks notice. So we will follow that. At this point, we do have some matters that need to go into executive session, which is dealing with confidential matters relating to the representation of indigent clients. So we need a motion to move into executive session.
Motion.
Now here's a second, we'll move into executive session.
Second.
All in favor to move into executive session at this point?
Aye.
Okay. All right, at this time we'll move into executive session. And we'll give Ms. Tisdale just a moment. And
leave the room, thank you very much. And will you call me when you reconvene before we recess?
Sure.
Thank you, I'll be waiting in your moment.
Should not be very long. Should be very long at all.
Thank you very much.
Sure. I think we can make ourselves comfortable. Okay. Come get you.
Thanks.
Sounds like a new state court judge, a new DA, and a new solicitor.
That's crazy.
All right.
During the executive session, we discussed a request from an attorney in relation to a request for something for her client that was approved. The matter is confidential due to dealing with the representation of a client. We also voted on the transcript request by one of our attorneys. That matter has been tabled due to additional research being done so that a policy can be created for all of the attorneys in reference to the transcripts. So, I believe that was all that was covered in executive session. Anything, there's, I see nothing else on the agenda at this time to be addressed. Anyone like to make a motion that we adjourn the meeting until the next one?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor of adjourning the meeting?
Aye.
Meeting is adjourned. Thank y'all very much.
Thank you, Connie.
Not a problem.
Yeah.
Okay. And please review if you have any questions about the open records, open meetings issues there. Tom will be glad to give us the attorney's opinion on that.
There we go.
Thanks, Tom.
Have a good day, folks.
Take care.
You too.
See, we always have all the junk to get together.
Mm-hmm. This video will be loaded on YouTube, and I have a channel, and it's youtube.com/Nydia Tisdale.
Oh, okay.
So you can look for it in a couple of days.
So do you do all the meetings, or?
I do a lot of Forsyth County meetings,
okay. Just kind
of, but not certainly not all, because okay. Some of them are scheduled simultaneously.
Right.
Right. So.
Just a secret.
Yeah, secret.